Guys, Ashish this side. So this is part 3 of study in Singapore video series, and in this part I'm going to tell you about cost of study and living, then we'll talk about scholarships, then we'll talk about post studies visa process, work permit, visa for spouse and post study options. So this is what we'll discuss in this video. So first thing that comes is cost of living. So cost of living depends on heavily on the parts of Singapore that you live. Mainly what you have is accommodation is major cost apart from tuition fee, but apart from that you have groceries, food, utilities, and how much you travel within the country and coming back to India are the major costs that occurs. With that, let's see what are the school expenses, the tuition expenses. The tuition fee varies according to different universities, courses in the city. The tuition expenses in Singapore for an undergraduate course might be up to 6.5 lakh to 8.5 lakh per year. And if you are thinking of applying to postgraduate course, then it can be around 9 to 15 lakhs. So approximately about 6.5 to 8.5 lakh for UG courses, while 9 to 15 lakh for PG courses. Now, next thing comes is living in Singapore. An international student in Singapore spends on an average about 40,000 to 1 lakh rupees on living expenses. So now again, it totally depends on how you manage. You can manage in around 40,000 also. And then if you go for an extravagant life, then it can be up to 1 lakh also. The amount varies, depends on individual lifestyle. Then the estimated cost give a rough idea guide to the basic monthly expenditure. Now, next thing that comes is scholarships. All the universities have merit and need-based scholarship or fee waivers awarded to international students. Candidates with strong academics, good performance on standardized exam and extracurricular achievements would be eligible for scholarship awards and financial assistance. Now comes the visa part. Your new visa application for students pass must be submitted at least 1 month and not more than 2 months before the commencement of the course. Application must be submitted through, now this is the portal which is called Solar System. Now it is not that Solar System, but this has a full form, which is Students Pass Online Application and Registration System, right? Following documents would be required for your application. So what you need is, you need valid passport, then complete student visa application form, which is ICA Form 16 and Form V36. Then application fee payment receipt, as you are required to pay about 30 Singapore dollars, which translates roughly to about 1500 rupees, and issuance fee of $60, which is about 3000 rupees, has to be paid to students pass and approved and issued. Then offer of place, you need to have an offer of place from a Singapore institute or university. The forms are usually issued after the tuition fee have been received. Then additional documents may be required during the personal interview. So additional document may be requested by the interview. These documents can be your transcript, diploma, degree, certificate from school you attended, your test score like TOEFL, GRE, GMAT, and then proof of funds as how you will pay all educational, living and travel costs is what can be asked for. Then what is the post-study visa process? So after the degree program is over, international students can submit an application for 1 year visa pass to ICA, Immigration and Checkpoint Authority of Singapore. If they want to look for employment opportunities in Singapore, this can be done through an EVP. Now, next comes is work permit. So let's see, you can work part-time for up to 16 hours per week in Singapore. And work permit are not required for those who want to work during holidays, as they can work full time without any visa requirement. Next comes is visa for spouse. So in case you are married, then this is for you. This can be helpful for you. The spouse and children of full time graduate research students can get a sponsorship from the university for a social visit pass to stay in Singapore. So it is called social visit pass. The graduate student should get their spouse and children to apply for an entry visa at Singapore's embassy. When the spouse and children arrive in Singapore, they will be given a 4-week social visit pass at the airport. Now, you have post-study options. What happens when you complete your course? So you have work visa. In Singapore, if you accept a job offer before you complete your studies, then what happens? Then your employer needs or will be applying on your behalf for employment pass. But what happens if you do not secure a job before you complete your course? Then you can apply for an approval in principle work visa, which allows you to stay for a limited time while looking for a job simultaneously. An employment pass is valid for a few years, that is about 3 to 5 years that you can stay and search for a job, get a job and work. This visa is linked with the job that you are doing, so that as long as you are gainfully employed by the employer, the work visa is in effect. So with this, we have come to the end of Study in Singapore series. I hope I have tried to cover as many things as possible. There's one thing, like the important exams, I have left in this series, because in all the series I have covered that. Plus we have dedicated videos for exams that you can explore. Along with that, if you have any query, then you can check the description on how to contact us. Please like this video, comment, share with your friends. Subscribe this channel if you have not subscribed yet. Apart from that, on this channel we have country-wise education series on different countries, or I can say on all the top countries that you can look forward for studying abroad. Now, apart from that also, there's lot of content on different courses, different universities, different countries that you can explore. So do explore that as well. I'll see you soon in some other video. Till then, stay connected.